So here we are in the bottom natural trap cave. We've been excavating for about 3 to 4 days. This is the area I've primarily been working in, so the surface was about up to here when we started. So about every day we get another foot deeper and deeper. And what we were trying to do was get through this layer of microfossils that was up here and get down into this clay layer. And it's in this clay layer we've been finding a lot of the bigger bones, and they're pretty well preserved as well. So we've been finding things like American lion, pronghorn, sheep ancestors, as well as some bison, but maybe not as much as Alan would hope for. So as you can see, we just take dental picks, and we're just very carefully removing the clay soil. And so what we're looking for is the difference between a bone and a rock. So the bone will be much more delicate and have a brighter tinge to it. And if you scrape on it, it won't turn white like the rocks will. So we just very carefully scrape around the bone. We also have paintbrushes to kind of clear clay out. And when we get something freed, we take it out and give it an analysis. So here's just a small fragment, but it'll still be cataloged, databased, and potentially used for ancient DNA research if the preservation is enough. So if Alan can zoom out, he'll show you kind of the whole excavation pit that we're in.
So we've started
working on some of this layer this year in 2014, but what we're really sitting in is a much bigger excavation pit that they stopped excavating in 1984. And what Alan is actually standing in right now is the original, very old pit. And as you can see, silt and water have come in and completely refilled the old pit. And so it's even managed to lock in a ladder permanently here. So we'll hope to recover a lot of this and get a lot of the garbage out from the 1984 excavation when we finish here.